from others. It gives each of us our individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character that guides one through life, and when once developed, grows steadily. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant action, striving daily to make the right choice. The problem of character is the problem of self-control. We must be, in reality, what we wish to appear to others. By demonstrating such qualities as respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship, we may hope to prove these by example that we value character. At this time, I would ask the new candidates to please rise. And we're going to take the pledge, if you'll raise your right hand. One at a time, I'd like you to say aye and state your name. Start at the far end. Say aye, John. Or D'Angelo. And the rest of the pledge will stay together. The next part goes, pledge to maintain high scholastic standing. To hold as fundamental and worthy, an untarnished character, to endeavor intelligently and courageously, to be a leader, and to give of myself freely in service to others. In doing so, I shall prove myself worthy of a place in the National Junior Honor Society. I pledge myself always to seek the light of truth, to hold scholarly habits, to engage in worthy service,